Ghost flow, oh God, in this place today. Let lives be changed in this place today, God. Let your supernatural love, oh God, begin to go well. It's never too early to worship. I mean, I know service is not starting yet.
Thank you. Darkness tries to hide. Christmas for myself and on behalf of Lighthouse of the Valley family. We're so glad that you're here. Now, the way I was brought up was when we had visitors, the visitors would stand. They might even tell a little testimony. Anybody ready to testify? I'm not going to have you do that, so I'm going to be a good guy. But if you're visiting us this morning, why don't you wave at me? Why don't you wave? Just wave at us. Come on, if this is your first. Come on, Lighthouse. Come on, Lighthouse. We are so glad that you are here. Amen. We are so glad that you are here. You could have been anywhere, but it is our pleasure to host you and to have you. Everything that we've been doing, we've been doing this since October in preparation with you in mind. But most of all, we are going to worship the audience of one, which is the Lord Jesus Christ. So although this might feel like a production and a performance, we're not performing for y'all. I'm sorry. Sorry to burst your bubble. But we're doing this because God deserved our absolute best. Amen. Some of you might be thinking, well, Jesus really wasn't born around this time. Who cares? We put the date on the calendar, and we're going to give him praise and glory for his birth. Amen. I want to thank everyone really quick, because we won't have a chance to do this later on, but I want to thank everyone that was involved in helping us in this production, whether you were in the music or the band. Brother Michael Thompson, he is our narrator. Everything that we're doing is actually in-house. We didn't strip nothing off YouTube. We use what the Lord gave us. Somebody say amen. Amen. We want to thank our media team. We want to thank Alex and Alfonso and Andy. We've been driving them crazy the last 72 hours. Turn me up. Turn me down. Pick me up. Put me down. No, just play. Don't pick me up. I'm scared of heights. Amen. But we are so glad that you're here. Just a quick announcement for you before we get started. We're going to be doing some things, so we're asking that you keep the aisles actually open. So don't have your children running through the aisles during the production. I don't want to run over them. You don't want me to run over them. Amen. Just saying they might get hurt. They might get hurt. If I see them, I'm going to trip on purpose. I'm going to be like, oh, you're in my way. I'm kidding. I'm nice. We're nice around here. We just joke around. We laugh. Also, there's going to be some strobing lights, so if you have epilepsy or if you're sensitive to lights or anything like that that might trigger a seizure, we just want to let you know the first song has a lot of that, so feel free to enjoy our vestibule area. But once again, we're glad to be here. We're glad that you're here. We're glad that everybody made it safe through the dense fog. But other than that, we want to present to you the Lighthouse of the Valley production, He Brought Joy to the World. God bless you.
Do you see what I see? Do you see?
The day is here. It's here. He's here. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, and the Prince of Peace. Let me tell you his story. Behold, a virgin has conceived she bears a son. His name is Emmanuel, meaning God is with us, our Lord and our King. He is here. Do you see what I see? For he shall grow up as a tender plant, a root out of dry ground. He shall have no form, nor comeliness, and no beauty that he should be desired. Come, look, witness.
Thank you.
there were shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of God shone round about them. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger.
Oh,
Now, even the children knew how important this night was. As they approached him in their innocence, they wondered, "What does all this mean? Who is this baby that they all fall and worship him? Why is he the center of attention? He is just a baby." But not just any baby. He's both Lord and Savior. He is King. In wonder, they knew there was something different about this child. Even as they pinched his rosy cheeks, I believe they were filled with his love and compassion for them. They too were greatly moved. The wise men saw the symbolism of his arrival. It guided them to their true King. They were filled with expectation and wonder of the coming of the King of Kings. This was the moment they had been waiting for. And yet, it was more than they would ever know. They came from the far east to Jerusalem, bringing gold, frankincense, and myrrh. As the saying goes, wise men still seek him.
Yeah. Stand to our feet at this time. We're going to take our offering and we're going to continue with the production here. Amen. Isn't it awesome? How many of you guys are having a good time today? It is so good to see everyone. Everyone looks awesome. Amen. How many of you guys feel the presence of the Lord? Amen. It's so good to see so many friends and family members and all the visitors, everyone here today. Amen. God is so great. We're going to go ahead and take some needs before the Lord. Amen. God is so faithful. God is so faithful. Amen. As the ushers come, amen, amen. God has been faithful. Quick testimony. I had a flight that I wasn't able to take, or they made a mistake with my flight back in February. And I had emailed them a couple times in March and April. They're supposed to give me back my money. It was like $1,000-something. And I emailed them. They never got it back. And then when I really needed it for another trip coming up, I emailed them last week. And I thought these people had, like, checked my money. You ever been scammed before? You do stuff online, you're like, I thought it was a ticket, right? They deposit that money back. I got my money back. God is faithful. How many of you guys, God has been faithful to you physically? He's been faithful to you spiritually, financially. Amen. We're going to go ahead and take our offering at this time. And if you're a visitor here today, don't feel the need that you have to give. But when you give, give cheerfully from your heart. Let's go ahead and pray over our offering today. And we want to remind you also, next Sunday, we are still having service. It will be at 11 o'clock. This morning, my kids said, are they having service on Christmas Day? I said, yes! It's about Jesus! We're going to have service! And yes, enjoying family and all of that and celebrating Jesus. So we are going to bump it an hour, and we're going to have service at 11 o'clock. Amen. Let's pray. Lord God, we thank you for this day, for this moment, for this time. Lord God, each and every one of us has come today, Lord, and we're hungry. We're thirsty for the things of God. There's so much going on in the world that people are paying attention to. But we come to acknowledge the name of Jesus Christ. You are the one that brought salvation, Lord. You are the one that brings true peace and true joy into our lives. And Lord, what a privilege to be able to give, to be able to offer up, Lord God, our small offerings, Lord. You have offered up, Lord God, your body as a sacrifice for us to be able to save us, Lord God, from our sins. And we say thank you. This is our reasonable service, Lord. Bless us as we give today. Bless us one by one. Bless us all together. Thank you for the church of the living God. Thank you for what you're doing around the world. Thank you for blessing our families, for providing our daily bread, and for just being a great God. We praise you and we honor you, and we thank you for what you're doing during this worship and the music. And at the end of the day, somebody's going to say, Jesus, I just want more of you. That's what this is all about. We give you the glory and the honor in Jesus' name. Let someone say, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. You may march down and give. Thank you.
And she brought forth her firstborn son. And because there was no room for them in the inn, she wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger. There was a warmth in the room that night. It kindled the bodies, hearts, and souls of all who were present, just like the warmth of the fire that kept their forefathers. It was magnificent, and it was holy.
Thank you.
you imagine the excitement, dancing, and joy in heaven? How wonderful was the celebration there? For the one here on earth had just begun, celebrating the awesome power and humility of our God, who came down to us. This must have been the greatest of all celebrations. All praises be to Jesus the Christ. And on this day, he brings great joy.
Thank you. Jesus. Have you been filled with the light of day? Has God blessed you? We have one more song, and we're just going to honor him. He is worthy of all the praise. You may be seated. God has been so good, so, so good. And I'm just so thankful that God has, he's done just so much. You know, every year around Christmas time, it gets a little difficult for us. But some years are good. 20 years ago, my mom passed away around Christmas time. And God has been so merciful, so loving, and just, there's not even sometimes words to describe how good God is. So I want to just encourage you, wherever you're at in this season of life, it can be heavy. You know, you're looking, there's a void, but I can testify that Jesus can fill that void.
That's right.
He can fill the longing in your heart. Whatever is missing, whatever hope that you've lost, let Jesus be that hope for you today. If you've lost your joy, God can renew that today. Amen. So I encourage you, as we sing this song again, this last song, just think about where you're at and just reach out to Jesus. He's never failed. He's not going to do it anytime soon, because that's not the God that we serve. So just worship with us as we sing.
Thank you. Choice. And so I would sit there on BART as we rode back to his place, to my grandfather's house, with that cookie and that soda, and I knew I was going to have the best weekend ever. And it didn't matter if we were just washing his car Saturday morning and watching cartoons, I knew that I was going to have the best time because I was with my Father. Jesus is the best Father you could hope for, and he promised that one day he died, he was buried, he rose again, but he promised one day to come back for his people. So I present to you our hope, our joy in the midst of sorrow, our joy in the midst of tribulations, our joy in the good times and the bad. Why? Because we're looking for our Father. We have that expectation. We're waiting. And don't you know that weekend is going to last forever? That weekend is going to last forever in a place built just for you. You can have joy this morning. And that's what the joy that the Lord faced joy. Jesus faced joy. Let me remind you, it says in Hebrews, therefore, since we were surrounded, But it says that, therefore, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses who by faith have testified to the truth of God's absolute faithfulness, he is faithful to you, stripping off every unnecessary weight and the sin which so easily and cleverly entangles us. Let us run with endurance and active persistence the race that is set before us, looking away from all that will distract us and focusing our eyes on Jesus. Jesus, who is our hope, who is the author and perfecter of faith. If you're struggling with your faith, lean on Jesus. Lean on Jesus, the first incentive of our belief and the one who brings our faith to maturity, who for joy, Jesus possessed joy. It says, who for joy of accomplishing the goal set before him endured the cross. He endured the humility, the shame, the weight of our sin, the pain that was inflicted upon his flesh. He endured it with joy. Why? Because he said, oh, I see some people that came to Lighthouse this morning. I see some people online right now, and they need joy. They need me. They need someone to bridge that gap. Why? Because one man, but one man sent into the world, but I'm that one man that's going to bridge them together. Place, I'm gonna tell you, that is God, that is Jesus moving in your life right now. And I encourage you to come up to these altars. He's saying, come on, make that first step. I already made the step. I adore the cross with joy for you, for you. If you're that one person, make your way forward, and he is here to forgive you. If you already know the Lord, if you already served him for years, I invite you still to come forward. I command God to share this good news, to share this good news. Oh, because the world
Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. God has done something special today. Have you felt like God has spoken to you today, that you feel a recommitment to your faith in Jesus Christ? I want you just to lift your hands right where you're at. Hallelujah.